Hello and welcome to This Week in Warhammer. My name is Max and I'm going to guide you through the next 7 days of your favourite hobby. Aeronautica Imperialis lifts off this week with two brand new factions, a new starter set and four new squadron packs. The Adeptus Astartes zoom into aerial contention from next week in a completely new box set for Aeronautica Imperialis. They'll be joined by the nimble aircraft of the Asiani in a rip-roaring dogfight between Raw Power and Xenos Grace. Aeronautica Imperialis Wrath of Angels is a new starter set for the Aeronautica Imperialis system, containing everything you need to get started, including 5 Adeptus Astartes planes and 6 for the Eldari, a 38-page rulebook, a scenario booklet, a double-sided game board, 8 dice, 70 assorted tokens and a transfer sheet. The 11 new miniatures in the box are brand new, with 3 Asurani Nightwings and 3 Phoenix Bombers, as well as 3 Space Marine Xiphon Interceptors and 2 Storm Eagles. This is a perfect way to get started with Aeronautica Imperialis or start a brand new fleet with one of the 2 new factions. The main fighter deployed by the enigmatic Craftworld Eldari, the Nightwing has a preternatural level of speed and maneuverability. This box set contains 6 Nightwings, which have 4 weapon options each and can be assembled with their wings locked forwards or backwards. And the Phoenix Bomber is the heavy Eldari strike craft, carrying a ground attack payload. It is an integral part of the Asiani war machine. This set contains 3 Phoenix Bombers, which have 3 weapons options and 2 missile array options each, and a set of Eldari transfer sheets. The Xiphon Interceptor has been used by the Astartes since the Great Crusade, and this box contains 6 Xiphon Interceptors and a Space Marine Squadron transfer sheet. Alongside those, there's the Adeptus Astartes Storm Eagle Squadron. The Storm Eagle is a Space Marine orbital assault craft that packs an overwhelming amount of firepower. This box contains 2 Storm Eagles and a Space Marine Squadron transfer sheet. You can't be expected to prosecute an air war without weapons, upgrades, and ace pilots. Fortunately, we've got you covered with these sets of faction cards. With 91 cards in the Asuyani set and 86 in the Adeptus Astartes set, these are all the quick references and special rules you'll need. There are also 2 aces in each set, as well as named planes and ground defenses to boot. We also have dice to allow you to roll into your air combat in style. Whilst there's already a fantastic double-sided game board in the Wrath of Angels box, you can't have too many areas of engagement. Aeronautica Imperialis Out of Reach's Area of Engagement is a new double-sided board, with a Lunar Imperial Outpost on one side and Volcanic Planetary Terrain on the other. The original ground assets from the first version of Aeronautica Imperialis return, featuring 16 ground assets and 14 plastic markers, including flak and missile batteries, bunkers and landing zones. This set adds a whole extra element to your games. We're going from the soaring skies to the Underhive now, where House Vansar is getting an arsenal upgrade. Give your Vansar the weapons they deserve with the new Vansar weapons and upgrade set. This set contains a vast range of new weapons, from shock mauls and servo claws to plasma cannons and rad guns. You'll also get 10 new heads, and it's all compatible with the main gang box and the Architects box. As always, we have a whole host of content dropping for you on Warhammer Plus. First up is Battle Report, and we're taking a dive into the brand new Kill Team game. Then the Loremaster takes a deep dive into the history of Ghazghul Thraka, while in Citadel Colour Masterclass, we learn all the tips and tricks you need to get started with glazing. The Vault, meanwhile, adds Shield of Baal Exterminatus, and 4 issues of White Dwarf. This is a bumper week from Black Library as well, including another bundle of print-on-demand editions from the Horus Heresy series. But first, Necrons, with The Twice-Dead King, Ruin, the latest novel from Nate Crowley. We've also got Silent Hunters, which follows the search of a chaplain from the Carcharodon's Astra chapter of Space Marines, as he goes on a journey searching for a lost relic. 5 more books from the ever-popular Horus Heresy series are being made available as print-on-demand hardback editions from next Saturday, again with no pre-order period. As always, we'll be keeping you entertained over on warhammercommunity.com. And don't forget to join us over on twitch.tv/Warhammer, where the Warhammer community team will be keeping you entertained. As always, to stay up to date with everything we've got going on, be sure to follow our YouTube channel, Facebook pages, Instagram, Twitter, and Twitch. That's all for this week. I'll see you next time.